Good afternoon, I'm meteorologist Matt Server with your midday Thursday update, and it's been a pretty soggy start to our day. Super Doppler 7 radar, you can see, has those showers and thunderstorms, a couple embedded thunderstorms still exiting out of here late this morning. They'll continue to push out of the Omaha Metro early this afternoon. We'll zoom back out and you can see this last little line that's kind of hanging around the Platte River, going over an area that's already seen several inches of rain. It'll slowly drag north and east. Should be out of here by about, I'd say noon at the absolute latest, but then it'll move toward Tecama, through Blair, over toward Woodbine and Missouri Valley, and eventually lifting through southwest Iowa. Look at some of these rainfall totals from around the area. Epley's right around 2 inches. Lincoln officially is over 3 inches, but really, there are three areas that saw really heavy rainfall. Again, right north of the Platte River from Columbus toward the Hupper area, and then down toward western Iowa, Shenandoah, Red Oak, Creston, anywhere between 2 and locally 5 inches of rain down there. And then, unfortunately, yet again, Seward, Saline, Lancaster County, 2 to 4 inches in those areas. So those are the areas where water is running really high. Now let's see where we're going to get more going into this afternoon. And I really like this run of our in-house model, our storm predictor model. It's been nailing pretty much everything all morning. So you can see that line of showers and thunderstorms lifting north of Omaha, kind of dissipating a bit through the early afternoon. But look what happens. Right around 3, 4 o'clock, as an area of low pressure, a cold front comes through, it's saying more showers and thunderstorms are going to start to develop pretty much right along the Missouri River, and then strengthen as they move through southwest Iowa, extreme southeastern Nebraska, northwest Missouri. And like I said, this one model run has been doing really well all day, so I'm putting a pretty good amount of stock into what it's saying here. So should be out of Omaha by about 5, maybe 6 o'clock at the latest, and then pushing south and east out of the viewing area by about 8 or 9 o'clock, and you can see just lingering showers as we go through the overnight hours. These are going to be really spotty and really, really light, but they could add more heavy rain in addition to potentially severe weather. Now, the SPC is going to be updating this in about an hour or so, but you can see it's still targeting south-central Iowa, northwest Missouri for that elevated risk of severe weather, and this could be large hail, damaging winds, and possibly, because we do have the area of low pressure, the warm front and the cold front, what's called the triple point, that's moving right through those areas, increased rotation, could see a couple of isolated tornadoes. Now, Omaha's right on the edge of that risk, and possibly if a storm fires up, it could become pretty strong right over us, but then it'll quickly move to the east. It's not like yesterday where these are just going to sit over us and dump a ton of extra rainfall, but southwest Iowa could pick up maybe another couple of inches of rain. To be complete, here are temperatures. You can see really not doing all that much today. We've been in the low 70s through most of the morning. Maybe we creep into the upper 70s early this afternoon before the front comes through, and then behind the front we'll drop back into the 60s. If you have any evening plans in Omaha, you might not need an umbrella. Again, we'll have those spotty showers coming in behind it, but if you were planning on playing softball, playing golf, anything like that, everything is just going to be drenched. So likely your outdoor evening events will be canceled, unfortunately, but there is drier weather in the forecast for just one day. You can get that forecast anytime. The 7-day forecast is on KETV.com. Bill Ramby will be in at 5, 6, and 10 tonight updating his forecast and putting a new video right here on KETV.com. So we still have one more round of possibly strong thunderstorms to get through this afternoon, then things really improve going into Friday. Have a good afternoon. I'll see you tomorrow morning on First News.